Hi, I'm Dr. Polozola with the LSU Ag Center. I'm a horticulture agent in the central region here. I'm also the state pecan specialist. I also get a lot of calls about home fruit production within the central region of the state. And to answer a lot of questions I was getting, I was started a strawberry trial because it's one of the perfect fruits for a beginning homeowner to start trying with. And I like it because it can grow in limited space in a pot, kind of like this. And you can grow a lot of different ones. This tiered table here has 12 different strawberry varieties I'm looking at. And there were a lot of different factors that I chose when starting this trial, including availability. What can you get at the nurseries in the spring, at Lowe's, Home Depot, even your just standard nurseries in Forest Hill? And that's kind of part on these. This is a Quinault and this is an All-Star. Very readily available in the trade, very large healthy plants. And then on the bottom there I have Ozark Beauty and Eversweet, and I'm discovering a lot of interesting things with it. The Eversweet was planted about the same time as the Ozark Beauty, but it's almost a dwarf variety in comparison, so that would make it great for containerized production. You could keep it in a pot this size year to year and not have to worry about transferring it out. Another factor that I think is interesting to look at for strawberries is ornamental potential. Now, one of the most ornamental qualities of strawberries are their flowers. So this is Gasana. It's a pink petaled variety. And I think it also has ornamental potential based off of the leaves as well, which are kind of bright green and glossy. Very vigorous. It doesn't make runners, so it's also very well suited for containerized production, or it doesn't make runners very readily. This is one I just started this year. It's part of the Proven Winner selection. Don't have a nice floral to show you at the moment, but they make a deep red, which is very attractive because most strawberry flowers are going to be white. So having a pink or a red definitely adds a splash of color, which is not very common in strawberries except for the fruit. Now, as far as actual fruit production, I would look at these two selections here. This is Sweet Charlie, and it's supposed to be very well suited for disease resistance in the hot and humid South. It was developed in Florida, very similar climate to us. So I trust the breeders there have selected and it will endure our heat and humidity very well. Another one is Albion, and it is quite tall and vigorous. Started these from bare root not too long ago. Excited about this selection. It does runner fairly prolifically, and you're going to have to cut those back in the first year, but it's definitely worth looking at in your garden. And then this is probably the one I'm most excited about, called Mara Du Bois. It's from a French breeding program. It's going to be softer, but it has much sweeter potential because of that. It's not really available in markets here because it's so soft they have difficulty shipping it to you, but it's much sweeter. In fact, the other day I got curious and ate a half sweet ripe berry of this, and it was sweeter than the ripe selections that I have elsewhere here. Okay, this is our traditional garden strawberry. It's a hybrid of two native berries. And this hybridization was done in France, just I guess to steal us from being able to claim it. But what it's a cross between is coastal strawberry, which is native all the way from Chile up the coast to California and even Washington. It has this nice glossy leaf. And then Virginiana, which is native obviously to the eastern coast and Virginia. These makes a lovely ground cover in the shade. Berries, I haven't tried my first one yet, but I'm really satisfied just with the growth pattern of both of these, and I think they have great potential as a ground cover in sunny and shady areas in the state. Now, there's a lot of different ways to grow strawberries, and I've done it for quite a bit. One thing you're going to want to look at is the type of pot. My favorite pot selection is terracotta. Now, this type of pot is called an azalea pot, and it's an azalea pot because it's short and stout. This is perfect for strawberries because they don't have a very deep or extensive root system. This big plastic container, for example, I have grown strawberries in containers like this for several years, and the roots only go about 3/4 to half of the way down. So it's kind of wasted space there, and they stay a little bit too wet. That's another factor I like about the terracotta. This terracotta has a very natural wicking effect. So this one here, which is a darker color, is adequately moist. This one here that has nothing in it is completely dry, and you can see it's a much lighter brown color. You can use this to your advantage and keep the roots dry to prevent diseases, and you know when to water. Once it gets this color, you need to start watering your strawberries. Now, as a warning, you will have to water more often in the summer, especially on windy days, because that wicking action increases in heat and wind. So you are going to have to water these once to twice a day in the heat of the summer. Now, this type of pot over here is actually called a strawberry pot. It has been used for strawberry production many, many years. And what you do is it has many holes in the sides, and you can plant individual plants in here, and they grow not quite as vigorous as they would given more space, but you get much higher quality strawberries if the birds don't get them first, because the berries hang out and they have good airflow around them. That is one thing, you're gonna have to mulch strawberries if you're growing them in a container and on the ground, because when they're in contact with the soil, they're much more sensitive to quality issues like molds and stuff like that. So it is very beneficial to have that. And you can even grow them in pots not terracotta. This is more of a concrete composite. Now, much more durable than the terracotta, but you don't get the benefit of the wicking. But if it's gonna be very dry, you may want this because it holds water much better. But in our wet seasons, you're gonna wanna watch them because it's really easy to overwater with that lack of wicking effect. This has been Micheal Polozola with the LSU Ag Center, and I hope to keep you updated with more of my findings with strawberries. Thank you.